Newstalk 720 WGN. Happy Friday morning to you. The weekend is here in the crosshairs. And if you're looking for something to do, why don't you get a ticket and go out and see this guy, Frank Caliendo. How you doing?
I'm doing pretty well.
Man, they got you working every time I look at the TV you're
Spike,
on.
You can tell them where I'm going to be. You don't just have to tell them I'm going to be out in Maryville.
Excuse me, you're going to be out in Maryville.
There's a guy who told you I was going to be somewhere and you didn't know where I was going to be, and then boom, I had to do it myself. I mean, you know, that's the thing about Spike, is he'll set you up, but you got to drive it home yourself. I mean, If Kerry Wood, if they had re-signed Kerry Wood, we'd say that was being Kerry Wood right now. But we got a new Kerry Wood here. So, I mean, with the new guy closing, you don't have Kerry Wood anymore. But you never know. You might have two Kerry Woods. I mean, in the city or in the woods, trees keep America. Please keep America looking good. Hoot, hoot, that's a Woodsy the Owl.
What would George W. Bush think of Kerry's departure?
Well, I was always liking it. I was like the fireballer. You know, a guy that could come in and, you know, shut the other team down.
Yeah.
With the hard stuff.
Wait, know. what about Donald Trump?
This is the most luxurious, amazing, incredible. What other adjectives can I think of right here?
Oh, man.
How can I? Let's see. He was the me of your team.
What?
I don't want to say, Kerry, you're fired. I don't want to say it.
What was the impression that brought you all the attention? What was the one?
Mad
was the one. I mean, I see that all the time. I see you on the set with those guys.
And, yeah.
But that was the one that brought you all the attention.
Yeah, and then the Bush impression.
Yeah.
And I look like a South Park version of Bush. Like a little round guy. Cartman doing Bush. I guess so. Sounds good to me.
But with the Bush impression, I mean, you got the voice.
The ass, you know.
You got to look at you. You've got
to
see
it. I call it a
pizza
slice.
Yeah.
You draw a line across the eyebrows and then down in a point at the chin, and that's where even with these chubby cheeks, you know, I can still bring it up, you know, ring it up, my friends. That's more McCain. My friends.
You do a great McCain. Yeah,
He had a lot of friends. Yeah. Apparently, not quite enough, but 46%. But my friends, you know, I'm working on the Obama. That's a tough one.
I don't know how you do that. I mean, he's got some quirkyisms the way he speaks.
Yeah, there's some. I think you know, I'm going to rely on my physical resemblance to him. it was all about change. We need change, and he thinks of every word.
Yeah.
You know, it's like the exact opposite of President Bush. We what we need is change. It's that. I just said stuff and hoped.
Yeah.
There it is. Hope and change.
Bush just flew out. But
whatever came out, came out. Yeah. Change. Isn't it the same thing a homeless person says?
Change.
These guys weren't fighting for the White House. They were fighting for a cardboard box. Come on. What we'll do is take that change, put it in a cup, and bail out the financial system. That's what Nancy Pelosi wants.
Yeah. Pelosi.
Whatever.
Yeah, okay.
I'm almost done. I don't care anymore.
He's a lame duck. Frank Caliendo's in the studio with us. He's performing tonight, 8 o'clock, the Star Plaza out in Maryville. Tickets are available there. Out in Aurora tonight or tomorrow night, that's almost sold out, right?
Yeah, pretty much sold out. There might be some singles and a couple in the back.
If you want to get out there and do that. He will be back with us after the news and stuff, and we'll put him in a couple of different situations and let you have at him.
Go.
Al Pacino, here we go.
Today, cloudy, breezy, mild, light rain early, showers in the afternoon, high 53. Tonight, cloudy, scattered rain and snow showers, low 36. Tomorrow, cloudy, blustery cold, scattered snow showers, high of 38. Bobby, you take it. Sunday, it's partly cloudy, breezy, cold, high of 38. The WGN 5-day forecast.
You don't have to do all that stuff.
Okay.
Just tell everybody it's officially 50 degrees at O'Hare.
It's officially 50 degrees at O'Hare. I am Bobby, and this is Spike.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you very much. Again, you've been listening to Frank Caliendo. He will be with us after the news, and we'll pick his brain about a few things going on in the world and get his take from different people that he represents in his own mind.
Thursday night football, Jets beat New England 34-31 in overtime.
How about that Jets team?
Yeah, I love Jet Favre. I mean, Jet Favre and the New York Brets. I mean, if there was ever a guy that I wanted on my team, it would be Jet Favre, and he's there. I mean, you know, the Big Apple just got a little bit tastier.
What's your favorite number?
It's four. Four.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm replacing it with the word Favre, though.
Oh, you are?
Yeah. 1, 2, 3, Favre, 5, 6, 7. And now my new favorite number is 5,500, Favre-de-Favre. Favorite holidays, the 5th of July. I mean, you think of all these things, and you realize, hey, I mean, how does the universe go on without Brett Favre, and it won't?
I don't know.
But at least he's here right now.
Thank you, John Madden.
Thank you, John. Fire losing the MLS playoffs. WGN Blackhawks update. They play tonight against St. Louis. Hawks pregame at 7:20. I'm Jim Memolo on the voice of the Blackhawks. News Talk 7:20 WGN.
Frank Caliendo's in the studio with us. You heard him as John Madden.
I'm trying to get him to help me with my workout.
You know what? Well, me too. You and I can work. Use it. You look good on a balance beam, I think.
Yeah. Right? When parallel. I'm parallel bars guy.
I do the iron rings. Yeah. And fall. Tell me about Frank TV. Everything going well?
Going well, yeah. This is our second season. We got the first part of the first season was cut short by the writer's strike. Came back. Yeah. Added two new guys, Mike McCray and Freddie Lockhart. They do a bunch of impressions. Freddie does like the Obama on the show does a great job with that. Mm-hmm. We try to take my act has always been taking from reality. And like William Shatner, this last week we did a sketch called Shatner Stones for Homes.
Okay.
And last year William Shatner had a kidney stone and he passed it and he put it on eBay. And so in our sketch, basically we have him eating as much salted pork as possible and trying to donate as much money to the good people at Habitat for Humanity. Just goofy kind of stuff like that.
But reality.
Fun stuff. Yeah. Fun reality and then taking it to the next, goofy step.
And when you come up with a new character, and there's always new people coming on the scene, do you go into a room and look at yourself in the mirror, or do you?
I don't look at myself in the mirror at all. Usually when I'm driving, driving. That's where I come up with a lot of stuff. Sports people are always big. Charles Barkley's been real big for me. That whole impression is based on the word terrible.
Terrible.
Because he thinks everything's terrible, but he doesn't say terrible.
Knucklehead.
Oh, no, that was terrible. That's a terrible, terrible play.
And Knucklehead, yes. It's like, why are you always quoting the Three Stooges?
I'm the Curly Joe of the Three Stooges. Come on, Knucklehead. That's terrible.
Where do the vowels go in that word?
T-R-B-L, terrible.
You couldn't play Scrabble with them. You gotta challenge them on
T-R-B-L. What's that? That's a triple word. It's going knucklehead. Come on. I just won, fool.
And if I were if I needed some psychiatric help or a counselor to help
Dr.
me.
Phil. Dr. Phil. I met Dr. Phil. Phil on purpose one time.
You met him?
Yeah. We did a sketch with him. Imagine every time I tell somebody that I met him, they're like, were you on the show with other crazy people who can't control the voices? you can imagine just yelling, Frank, you got to stop pretending to be other people. Just be yourself. Hey, I'll stop pretending to be other people as soon as you stop pretending to be a doctor. How about that? The only guy I trust less with their doctor advice, Dr. Pepper. That's a Mr. Pibb joke.
Can you hang around here for let's take a quick break, do the traffic, we'll come back in about a minute. I want to talk about that night you went on Leno, and that was hilarious.
Oh, thank you. Thank you.
And I'm not sure Jay, I don't know if he liked your impression of him, but it was dead on. It was dead on. Friday morning, November 14th, Frank Caliendo's in the studio with us, star of Frank TV. You see him on the football set every Sunday, too. Yeah.
Which Jerry one? Bradshaw, not putting it, Frank.
Does he give you a hard day?
Oh, yeah. It's just part of the game, but he's a very good guy, TB.
Does Howie like you?
Yeah. Howie's very funny. He's always been great to me. One time we were sitting at the Super Bowl, and Howie, I saw him watering down a Diet Coke, and I'm like, what are you doing watering down a soda or a pop, I think it's what are you doing watering that down? He's like, Frank, I do a lot of weird things. I'm kind of a weird guy. I just left it at that. So
you're famous for that appearance on the Jay Leno show here several months ago, and you started doing Jay Leno. Did he like that, or was that just his way of giving you a hard time?
No, he liked it. I mean, I actually just did it again the other day, and I did the whole interview. I started doing his parts. I was like, so what do you think about? What do you think about that? I'm not really sure what I think about that. What do you think about it? I wanted to bring up that, and I forgot to do it, that he and his voice and Mike Tyson are very similar. I'd love to see, Mike Tyson be interviewed by Jay. Hey, what do you think? Why'd you bite that guy's ear off? I'm not sure why I did it. Why do you think I did it? I don't know why I did it.
Kim Jong-il just blew up Jay Leno's head. That's a knucklehead move. That's crazy. That's terrible, horrible, and really, really bad.
Oh, man. Does Leno like that?
Yeah. They just goes, last time I went on Letterman, I walked down with my zipper down, and I didn't do it on purpose. He's like, hey, are you trying to make extra friends here? That's like, is that how you make friends here? Then I started doing him to him. What I like to do bring people on, point out their flies down. What do you think about that, Paul? Awkward, Dave. Awkward. So when you have somebody else's voice in your back pocket to go back at them with, it always works.
As a guy who does impressions for a living, is that the first thing that hits you as a person's voice? Or is it their mannerisms?
Stuff.
Or?
I mean, there's all kinds of different stuff. Yeah. Like, my son has this little part of his face that was looked paralyzed to me, or it moved slower. Yeah. And I said to the doctor, I go, I'll bet he had Bell's palsy at some point. And the doctor looked at me like I'm crazy. And I got him working on it, his, you know, to build the muscles there. We go to a specialist. They're like, oh, yeah, he had Bell's palsy. How did you ever see it? I'm like, well, I'm like Predator. I map everything out. I see people in grids.
The little things that they do. Stuff,
So it's like, you know, it's a blessing, curse kind of situation. You know, you love your child as much as you could ever love him, but you see a flaw. Like, I see him smile, and half the smile comes slower than the rest. So it was, like, you know, you don't love him any less, but you just want your kids to be perfect, you know? So, but that's the thing. I see everything. That's why I can't watch myself on TV. I see every flaw. And believe me, there's a lot of them.
You're like, I can't listen to myself on tapes either. I don't want to hear them.
Yeah, it's tough.
I don't want to hear them. Hey, he's out at the Star Plaza in Maryville tonight. There are some tickets available for that, but get them while you can. Tomorrow night, 8 o'clock, out at the Paramount Theater in Aurora. Those tickets are just about gone. You might be able to get a couple more. And you can watch Frank TV Tuesday nights, TBS, about 10 o'clock right here.
Yeah, 10 o'clock and then every Sunday. Not funny, Frank. Come here and shine my head, Frank. Park my car, shine my head.
A local guy, grew up in this
Waukesha. Born in a lot of family in Elmwood Park and stuff like that. Born in Chicago, My dad's.
Well, man, it's nice to meet you. You're like one of the hottest guys going right now, and to come in. And
you're one of the smartest guys.
Oh, that was very charming, very charming. Frank, thanks so much and good luck, and we'll see you on the tube.
I appreciate that, my friend.
Thank you, Mr. President.